This is a part 3 of question and answers, nutrition, food supplying system of class 10 biological science. How is the small intestine designed to absorb the digested food? Explain. The small intestine is the main region for the absorption of digested food. The inner surface of small intestine has millions of tiny finger-like projections called villi. Due to the presence of villi, the absorbing surface of small intestine increases. The digested food, which is absorbed through the walls of intestine, goes into our body. Into our blood, because each and every villi is connected with the blood vessels. Next question: how are fat digested in our bodies? Where does this process takes place? How fat creates a enzyme? Bile juice, and which emulsifies large fat globules into small fat globules, and lipase or of pancreatic juice breaks down small fat globules. So what they will do, they have large fat globules into small fat globules, and lipase which are released from the pancreatic juice breaks down small fat globules further. The enzyme present in the intestine juice breaks down fats into fatty acids and glycerols. The process of digestion of fats takes place in the small. Next, what is malnutrition? Explain some nutrition deficiency diseases. So what is malnutrition? Mal means bad. So bad nutrition. Eating food that does not have one or more than one nutrient in required amount is known as malnutrition. If it is lacking carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals or fats, anything, whatever it is lacking. So it is not a complete nutritious. So poor health will with full starvation, lack of awareness of nutritional habits, social economic factors are also reasons for malnutrition. What are the types of malnutrition? There are of three types, that is calorie malnutrition, protein malnutrition and protein calorie malnutrition. So when we have the deficiency of protein, what type of diseases occur? Kwashiorkor disease occur with the deficiency of what? Proteins. Body parts becomes how? If protein is not has taken in a sufficient amount, swollen due to accumulation of water in the intercellular spaces, very poor muscle development, swollen legs, fluffy face, difficulty to eat, diarrhea, dry skin are the symptoms of this disease. Marasmus. This is the deficiency of what? Both protein as well as calories. Generally, this disease occurs when there is an immediate second pregnancy or repeated childbirth, lean and weak swelling limbs, less developed muscles, dry skin, diarrhea, etc. are the symptoms. Obesity. Why obesity occurs? It is the overeating. Whatever we are eating, it should not be in excess, it should not be in less amount. It should be in a balanced way. Okay? This is due to overeating and excess of energy intake. It is a big health hazard. Obese children, when they grow, they will be a target of many diseases like diabetes, cardiovascular, renal, gallbladder problems. Next question is, what process do you follow in your laboratory to study the presence of starch in leaves? So what is the process we have seen in our lesson? That is, take a leaf of a potted plant which has soft thin leaves, boil the leaf in a methylated spirit over a water bath till it becomes pale white due to removal of chlorophyll. Now observe the leaf. Spread the leaf in a dish and add few drops of tinctured iodine or betadine solution on it. Observe the leaf. The presence of starch will be indicated by the blue-black color. Next question. How would you demonstrate that green plants releases oxygen when exposed to light? Experiment. What we have to do? A hydrilla plant. Oxygen means, you just keep in your mind that you have to write about the hydrilla plant, okay? To prove that oxygen is produced during photosynthesis by hydrilla funnel experiment, beaker with water, test tube, funnel, hydrilla twig, glowing sphincter procedure. What is the procedure? Arrange the apparatus as shown in figure. You should draw the procedure. In your textbook, it's there. Place water plant hydrilla in a beaker containing pond water and cover these by the stemmed funnel. Okay, invert the test tube full of water over the stem of the funnel. Ensure the level of water in the beaker is above the level of the stem of the inverted funnel. So it should be above the funnel where it is ending, the funnel we have used in which the hydrilla plant is kept, and the water should be above that in the beaker, and the funnel you should keep in the beaker containing water, and you should put under the sun. Place the apparatus in the sun for at least 3 days. Often, sometimes it is observed that gas bubbles come from the hydrilla plant. These bubbles are collected at the end of the test tube by pushing the water into the beaker. After sufficient gas is collected, the test tube is taken out of the beaker carefully by closing it with the thumb. Observation. What is observation? Test the gas in the test tube by inserting a glowing incense stick which would burst into flames. What it will do? It will burst into a flame. This shows the presence of oxygen reserve. This shows that oxygen is produced during photosynthesis. So this is the diagram of our alimentary canal. Let's see them. What are the process taking place? Only if we say draw the diagram of alimentary canal, you should draw like this: salivary gland, mouth, salivary gland, parotid gland, esophagus, stomach, liver, here pancreas, here green color gallbladder, and this is small intestine, and here large intestine, here is rectum and anus, and this small thing is the appendix. Okay. That's it. Now, if you have to draw the chloroplast diagram like this. Explain the necessary condition for autotrophic nutrition and what are its byproducts. So, autotrophic nutrition takes place through the process of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll pigment and sunlight are the necessary for autotrophic nutrition. Carbohydrates and oxygens are the byproducts of photosynthesis. Byproducts are carbohydrates and oxygen, and what it is you what it will use for the process to take place: carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, pigment and sunlight, and this is a autotrophic nutrition. Where do plants get each of the raw material required for photosynthesis? Where do they get all these carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll and sunlight? Carbon dioxide from atmosphere, water from groundwater, solar energy from sun, chlorophyll is present in the leaf. What will happen to protein digestion as medium of intestine is gradually renders alkaline? The food coming from the stomach to intestine is acidic in nature. Bile and pancreatic juices render the internal condition of the intestine gradually to a basic or alkaline one. In the alkaline medium, pancreatic enzyme trypsin can act on the food and digest the proteins. The enzyme present in the intestinal juice completes the digestion of proteins into amino acids. Always remember, proteins are digested into amino acids. Okay, fats into lipases and carbohydrates into glucoses. Okay, what is the role of roughages in the alimentary canal? Roughages are the fibers of either carbohydrates or proteins. They keep the person healthy by keeping the intestine working and moving other food quickly through the alimentary canal. How do non-green plants such as fungi and bacteria obtain nourishment? How they will get? Bacteria and fungi are non-green plants, so they can't penetrate their own food. They can't prepare their own food because they are not in a green color. They don't have chlorophyll. So what they will do? They are saprophytes, which feed on dead and decaying plants and animals. So what they will do? They will feed on what? Dead and decaying plants and animals. The fungi and bacteria breaks down the complex organic molecules present in the dead and decaying matter and convert them into simpler substances outside the body. These simpler substances are the absorption of fungi and bacteria as their food. Okay. Next question. If we keep on increasing the carbon dioxide concentration in air, what will be the rate of photosynthesis? If carbon dioxide is more, what will happen to the rate of photosynthesis? The rate of photosynthesis increases as the carbon dioxide concentration increases. Gradually, the rate of photosynthesis falls at a certain carbon dioxide concentration. The rate of photosynthesis stays constant. How much we want to eat, we will eat that much only. We can't eat more than if our stomach is full. Can we take more food? How much is available in front of us? We won't take. How much tasty it will be? We won't take. So, same happens here also. It remains constant. Okay. Here, a rise in carbon dioxide level has no effect on the rate of photosynthesis as the other factors such as light intensity become limited. Okay. Next. What happens to plants in the rate of respiration becomes more than the rate of photosynthesis? Respiration is the catabolic process and photosynthesis is the anabolic process. In catabolic process, bigger molecules are broken down into smaller molecules like glucose molecules into carbon dioxide and water as in respiration. In anabolic process like photosynthesis, from simple molecules like oxygen and water, complex carbohydrates are produced in plants. Both constructive and destructive process must occur in a plant for its normal growth. If respiration overtakes photosynthesis in a plant, it is starved off from the supply of food and thereby it gets etiolated and finally it leads to the death of the plant. What happens? If there were no green plants, all life on earth would come to an end. Comment. Because we need oxygen for living. If green plants are not there, means no oxygen is there. And we required now food also. Let's see. Plants play the important part in life cycle of nature. Without plants, there would be no life on the earth. Plants are the only organism that can make their own food and all other living beings directly or indirectly depends on plants for their food. Moreover, plants release oxygen into the atmosphere through photosynthesis. Oxygen is essential for the organisms to respire. Hence, without green plants, all life on the earth would have come to an end. If plants are almost all the living world depends on plants for food material. How do you appreciate the process of making food by the green plants? Among all the living organisms on the earth, only plants are capable of producing their own food and deriving energy from it. No other living creator can produce their food and thus depends on plants directly or indirectly. Through photosynthesis, plants take energy from the sun, carbon dioxide from the air and water, minerals from the soil. Then they give off water and oxygen. Plants are the primary producers and it sustains all other life forms. Life without photosynthesis would thus be impossible. Next question. What food habits are you going to follow after reading this chapter? What you will do? The food habits I am going to follow after reading this chapter are: I will take balanced diet which contains proper amount of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals and vitamins. I will avoid taking food containing high proportion of fat, means oily food, chips and all. I will eat food as much required by my body. I will not overeat. Overeating is not good. Okay. I will not eat rich meal over several days. Rich meals means eating very rich meals over days, means 1 or 2 days is okay, but taking daily is not okay. I will eat simple balanced meals Eat it leisurely and thoroughly, masticating the food. Leisurely means not in a hurry worry. Leisurely you sit down and masticate. Chew it very nicely and then swallow. I will avoid doing violent exercises soon after eating food. I will empty the bowels regularly, avoiding constipation. I will seem to have plenty of roughages in the diet. And one more thing you should add, taking a lots of water. Okay. Why it is better to call the dark phase of photosynthesis as a light independent phase? The term dark reaction does not mean that they occur when it is dark at night. It only means that the reaction does not depend on light. Hence, we call the dark phase of photosynthesis as the light independent phase. Okay. Why is it necessary to discharge a plant before performing any experiment on photosynthesis? It is necessary to discharge, discharge means the starch we keep before performing any experiment, we discharge it. How we discharge it? By keeping the plant into a dark room for 3 to 4 days. It is necessary to discharge a plant before performing any experiment on photosynthesis, because if starch is present, it may interfere with the experiment. Why photosynthesis is considered as a basic energy source for most of the living world? All the living things constantly need energy to be alive. They get the energy in the form of food. The food directly or indirectly comes from the green plants through photosynthesis. Hence, photosynthesis can be considered as a basic energy source for most of the living world. Why is it not possible to demonstrate respiration in green plants kept in sunlight? We can't demonstrate an experiment of respiration in green plants because of sunlight is present. The carbon dioxide produced in respiration will be used in photosynthesis. So we must conduct an experiment on respiration in green plant in a dark room. Name the 3 end products of photosynthesis. Glucose, oxygen and water are the 3 end products of photosynthesis. What is the connecting substance between light reaction and dark reaction? Stroma is the connecting substance between light reaction and dark reaction. What? Stroma. What is the role of acid in stomach? HCl found in the stomach helps in killing harmful germs which may have come along with the food. HCl, hydrochloric acid, creates an acidic medium which facilitates the action of enzyme pepsin. Pepsin is active in the presence of hydrochloric acid. What is the function of digestive enzymes? The function of digestive enzyme is to increase the process of complex substances into simpler and absorb molecules. This makes easy for the body to absorb food. What is the role of saliva in the digestion of food? Saliva is secreted by 3 pairs of salivary glands in the mouth. Human saliva contains an enzyme called amylase that converts starch into maltose. That is from amylase, is other name is stilin, and the maltose, which is a sugar form of carbohydrates. Okay, it is converted into a starch into a maltose. The food is mixed thoroughly with saliva and move round the mouth while chewing by the muscular tongue. Why do you think that carbohydrates are not digested in the stomach? For the digestion of carbohydrates, the enzyme ptyalin or amylase are required, which are produced where? In the mouth by the salivary glands. Okay. The gastric juice produced by stomach does not contain the enzyme ptyalin or amylase. It contains only pepsin, which digest only proteins. Hence, carbohydrates are not digested in the stomach. They are digested partially in the mouth and completely in small intestine. Okay. Thank you.